Hi, this is Michelle Barnacle again. Now we're going to talk about some subtraction word problems. When you do subtraction basic, it's already written there for you, but sometimes the wording makes it a little confusing. When it asks you to find the difference, like the examples that are on the screen right now, remember that the word difference from the previous lesson says it is the answer to a subtraction problem. So that means simply take 91 and we're going to subtract 65. In example B, it says find 105 less 12. Anytime you see that, the word less means subtraction, so you would want to write 105 subtract 12. Okay, and then it says subtract 620 from 1,000. That means that the 1,000 would go on top, the 620 would go on the bottom, and then you would subtract. We're going to work that one right now, so we're going to switch to the board. So we're going to say 1,000, and we're going to subtract 620. When you do this subtraction, when you have a bunch of zeros, when you take 0 minus 0, you get 0, and that's easy. But when it comes to taking numbers away from 0, that is where you have to borrow or regroup. So because I cannot take 2 from 0, I am going to borrow. And when you borrow one from next door, remember he becomes the 9. And the one that you borrow to get becomes the 10. Okay? And that means that's 10. Take away 2 leaves 8. Okay? And then I borrowed one from him, so he became a 9. So that's 9 take away 6 leaves me 3. The one that's left over, I had to borrow. So since I had to borrow, he becomes a 0. So when you have 0 minus 0, you do not have to put the 0 in front. All we are left with is 380. And remember that you want to make sure that you add to see if you did this correctly. All right. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to go through a word problem. So the word problem talks about somebody's blood pressure, and it says that the blood cholesterol level, not blood pressure, the cholesterol level is 243. Okay? And we need to decrease it to 185. So in order to find out how much we need to go down, we're going to take away, because that's what decrease means. We're going to take away what we need so we know how much we have to decrease it. Now, right here, when we go to the ones column, I have 3 take away 5. Since you can't do that, remember you have to borrow from next door. So when I borrow, he becomes 13. And the one that I borrowed, he goes from a 4 to a 3. So 13 take away 5, I can do that. That becomes an 8. But when I look at the tens column, I see 3 take away 8. I can't take 8 from 3, so I have to borrow again. So when I borrow next door, the 2 goes down to a 1, and the 3 becomes a 13. Now I can take away. 13 take away 8 leaves 5. And then in the hundreds column, that's 1 take away 1 leaves nothing. So I must need to decrease my blood cholesterol level by 58 points in order to get it down the way the doctor wants me to. Anytime you're solving word problems, you want to make sure that you read the problem carefully to know what you're looking for. The last thing we're going to talk about, we're going to switch to the screen. And we talk about properties of subtraction. Properties of subtraction are similar to properties of addition, but you will notice that you do not get the same thing. When you take 10 minus 7, you get $3 left over. But if you have 7 and you owe 10, you're not going to get the same $3. That means that you owe 3 more dollars, and that would be a negative number, and that is not commutative property. Because commutative property means that you get the same thing front and back. The next one with the associative property, that was the one where you had the parentheses around it. So if you do the first part, you do 7 take away 1, that leaves 6. 10 take away 6 leaves 4. But when you go to the right-hand side, you do 10 take away 7, that leaves 3. And 3 take away 1 is 2. Those are not the same, so the associative property is not true. The only property that is true is 0, because 5 take away 0 is still 5. That's all we have to say about subtraction, and good luck on that part of the self-quiz.